Hi guys, I'm Johnny from CineD, and the much anticipated Panasonic Lumix GH6 is finally here. I was working with it for a few days and I came back with a solid opinion. This is the best all-around camera Panasonic has ever produced. No matter if you're working in news or as a creative creator, you will find this to be a very solid product to work with. In this review, I will mainly let the picture talk for themselves. This will be the best way to demonstrate how far Panasonic went with developing this product. Like you guys, I was very curious to find out if Panasonic finally managed to nail the autofocus system within this new camera. And the answer is absolutely yes. Indeed, it is still a contrast-based DFD system, but it seems as if the new Venus engine did really well in supporting the autofocus system. In fact, in order to prove a point, I'm filming myself with the GH6 and the autofocus is fully engaged. Now, a few days ago, I had a chance to meet Helmut. He's a general manager by trade, but a bird watcher by heart, and we spent a few hours together searching for birds. I can't say that the birds really cooperated with us, but since we are not filming for National Geographic, this was not an obstacle. What came out clearly is that the autofocus system works really well, no matter what I filmed. There is one fundamental condition though, and it's the need to update any of the Panasonic lenses you might have in order for the autofocus to perform well. Thankfully, the update will be available for free by the time you see this video. Look at this shot I took, where the camera is placed outside of the car, and see how well it can maintain focus although there is a glass and reflections between the GH6, Helmut and me. And this brings me to the next camera improvement, the stabilization system. Over time, Panasonic developed a reputation of having a solid body lens stabilization performance, but I think they did even better with this 5-axis dual IS2 system. Needless to say, that lenses without any built-in stabilization can be used, as the camera body's IS still functions.
This is really unusual. There's not even one bird here. Usually you can see great white egrets here, at least some coots, but not even one singular coot. This is... I haven't been at this place here where it was so empty. But well, I guess we have to find another place which is better.
Next on the agenda is the 5.7K up to 30p ProRes internal recording, and the Lumix GH6 is the second mirrorless camera after the Nikon Z9 to use that recording codec internally. It comes in two flavors, 10-bit 4:2 or 10-bit 4:2 HQ. The only difference is the data rate. Future firmware update will bring the ability to record ProRes internally in DCI 4K, 4K and Full HD. All in all, it is such a relief to see a proper codec being implemented in this camera, simply because of the high quality video recording and easy editing. But maybe the most significant improvement of this new camera over its predecessors is the dynamic range boost function. So forget what you know about dual ISO, meaning two separate best ISO settings, and welcome two constant ISO recordings, high and low. They merge into one single output. How this is done in real time is beyond my technical expertise, but obviously it is like having constant HDR recording. And what really matters is that it's the first time I feel like Panasonic got it right. No more too clean image that feels like it is controlled by extreme noise reduction. When filming in this mode, the video has a very organic feel to it, with a pleasant noise texture and, not less impressive, a higher dynamic range indeed. Mind you that if you choose to record in DR boost mode, here is what you need to know in order to enjoy this new feature. DR Boost is available in up to 60 frames per second. Base ISO in VLOG or HLG is 2000. If you are into filming in lower ISO settings, you must turn off the DR Boost. But I recommend to leave it on since you're gaining at least 2 stops of dynamic range. My colleague Gunther confirmed this in our Lumix GH6 lab test. So just to conclude, recording in ProRes is superior to H.265, not only because it's a much better codec, but also because H.265 in this camera crashes the shadows. So turn DR Boost on for better performance. All those improvements lead to a much nicer color aesthetic. If in the past I highlighted the fact that Panasonic images are so hard to grade, kind of being too reddish, now it is a thing of the past. Other enhancements to mention within this model are greater audio control with up to 4 recording channels when using Panasonic's XLR adapter, and on top, a very easy access to most of your audio settings is now possible by clicking the new audio info button. Heat management is also highly improved as the new GH6 is now following the S1H with a proper active cooling system. If you are a slow motion freak, this camera offers 4K in 120 frames per second and a full HD up to 300 frames per second. I also want to quickly note the following new features. There is a front-back tally light, front recording button, there is an anti-rotation pinhole for tripod camera plate, and in terms of powering, be sure to use Panasonic's new batteries, as this is the only way to record in full resolution and ProRes. Older ones will fit, but you will be restricted to recording up to 4K in a MOV container. I already mentioned that a future firmware update is coming, and next to the additional ProRes recording options, it will have USB SSD direct recording. At this stage, it is not clear what type of external recording will be available, but let's hope for a cinema DNG option. HDMI 4K 120p RAW video data output for the Atomos Ninja 5 Plus will also be available. And Panasonic is promising more, but it's not clear what exactly. Now, of course, like with any other camera, nothing is perfect in life, and there are a few things that I would like to highlight. Let me start with the camera's design, and although it might be nice for using older accessories, it is really a missed opportunity here. In my opinion, the new camera simply deserves a new modern look. Then there is the EVF. All in all, I wish if they were higher quality to make manual focusing easier. On top, the EVF cannot be controlled over the camera menu, and again, I cannot tell if it's only on my sample unit, but it constantly flickers depending on how bright or dark the object is. Next on my list is the momentary freeze when starting to record in ProRes. It is not really comfortable to work like this. Last but not least, here is a weird thing I only noticed now. When using manual lenses and accidentally pressing the lens release button, the picture will go black. I'm not sure if Panasonic is trying to protect some of the electronics here, but with some manual lenses, this can turn into an issue depending on how close the aperture ring is to the camera body. Conclusion. And let me start by asking if a Micro Four Thirds camera still has a valid place in today's market. My answer is absolutely yes, but mainly because of the vast amount of lenses out there. Originally, MFT had the upper hand when it comes to camera size, but in modern times, this advantage has disappeared. In regards to the Lumix GH6 itself, I really like what Panasonic did here. Okay guys, this is for today. Thank you very much for watching. Please don't forget to subscribe to our YouTube channel, and if you want to comment, please below. Thank you.